This is the exact bike you would get if you guys own a Specialized Tarmac S-Works SL7 and you ran into any kind of warranty or crash replacement issues. It is in a gloss black with a white decal on there. In my personal opinion, I think it looks classic. I think it looks stealth. I think it looks beautiful. But I might be just be saying that because of the fact that you can't actually buy this frame. So you guys heard me right. You cannot buy this frame if you want this frame. The only way to obtain it is if you run into a warranty issue. Now, some of you guys might hate it. You guys might think, hey, I just spent $5,500 on a paint job that I loved, and now they're only giving me the option to replace it with this frame. But this is kind of the rules of what Specialized has, and I'll kind of go through that whole warranty process on there. But as you guys can see, it's a nice gloss black. We had the classic white decals everywhere. It looks phenomenal. I did a video on this bike back in the day as well. Just a couple months ago, a customer had an expert Tarmac SL7, and he had the same situation with a warranty issue, and they went ahead and they swapped out his frame for him as well. Just instead of saying S-Works, it said Specialized. But they're starting to go ahead and deem the frames that they have issues with and give these back to the consumers with a warranty frame, so that way they're able to keep track which customers had a warranty and vice versa. Now again, I might be upset if I found the color of a frame. Let's say I waited 3 or 4 years, 5, 6 years even, to find the exact bike I wanted. I got to choose the color I wanted. I'm like, this is my last bike. I'm not buying any more bikes. And then I have a warranty issue that's not my fault, and they kind of give me this option. Maybe then you can work with a Specialized retailer or Specialized directly to maybe get yourself a different frame. But a lot of people have seemed to be choosing this frame. I don't think it looks that bad. Now, the customer also had components. He had an issue with a wreck on those components on a different bike. So he just went out. We got the frame in for him. We got brand new parts in there as well. So this was a brand new build with this frame. So it looks, like I said, I am a sucker for classic all gloss black and white. I miss this color a lot. I think they should give this color out in every single model bike they do to give the consumer a choice, but I'm a big fan of it. There are some different components we change out, like these NV bars that aren't the stock Roval bars. But again, I think this bike came out super clean. So I'll have the weight of this bike at the end of the video too, if you guys want to check it out. Just to give you guys a full rundown, this is the new 12-speed all-taker DI2. It's a full buildup. We do have a stages power meter crank on the non-drive side. We can see the power meter pod right here. So this one does have the outfitted power meter on this side as well. We do have the different NV bars. These are actually a size 38 centimeter bar from hood to hood. And we can see the flare out there. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I think I'm the best handlebar wrap job guy here on this platform. Any mechanics you know, we'll do a wrap off on there. But man, look at that. Look how clean that is, dude. Super clean. Absolutely beautiful. The bike came with the S-Works stem. It comes with the Garmin mount as well. And then we did a S-Works Roman Evo saddle, carbon fiber rails, carbon fiber body. Quick fact for you guys, the Roman Evo saddle is actually lighter than the S-Works Power saddle as well. I know a lot of people think that the S-Works Power saddle is lighter because it's smaller and looks a little bit less mass. It's not. The Roman Evo is actually lighter. And then for the wheels, we just did Roval C38 wheels. They wanted to save on them. Great wheels, $1,100, 38 millimeter depth wheels. And then you get the Roval crash replacement program on there as well, which is nice. Lifetime warranty on the wheels, lifetime warranty for the crash replacement as well. Great training wheels. They come with a DT Swiss 370 hub. You can swap out ratchets in there. They have a huge upgrade. And then just circular spokes. But again, they did the big upgrade on the DT Swiss 370. Altega rotor is 160 in the front, Altega rotor 140 in the rear. And then my favorite part of this bike, which I've been selling the crap out of these bottom brackets, this is an Originate bottom bracket. It's a machined alloy bottom bracket, which is the standard bearing there. But this thing is so buttery smooth. I mean, like, I did a video on my Instagram. If you guys didn't know, check out my Instagram, GC_Performance_. I did a video on my Instagram without a channel here and did a spin test on this bike. These things spin so freely, it's literally like ceramic speed. Not ceramic bearings again, that bottom bracket's only $40. Originate's kind of known as a budget group set or budget component, but it came out so nice. So, what do you guys think about this whole situation? Again, the frame is beautiful. You can't deny that, but think about the situation if you're in there. You spend a lot of money with a company, and this is the only option they give you. Yes, it's a way for Specialized to keep track. I believe it's only for their higher tier bikes as well. I believe it's only for their Tarmacs, their Epics. I know they have that for the S-Works Epic and S-Works Epic Evos. I don't know about the stump jumpers of that, but they're really sought after bikes. They want to keep a separate batch of frames for that reason, just so they have them in stock, so that way they wouldn't sell through them. back in the day, they used to have frames in stock that you can do. But even that, people will complain and say, hey, you paid a lot of money for this color. Why don't I get that? Even back in the day, 5-6 years back in the day, they would run out of the color that consumers will buy. Let's say they went after this color, they had an issue with it, they would run out of that color, so then they have to offer them a different color that they didn't like anyway. So it's kind of the same situation. This way they actually have a batch of warranty frames to get these consumers, because they're really scared that they're not gonna have any availability, which they do because they're not allowed to sell these aftermarket. So that way there is a dedicated batch for people who do spend a lot of money with them to get a frame right away. And yeah, I mean, it's a beautiful frame. And you also have a lot of options down the road. You could put a custom decal kit on this S-Works, on the Specialized logo, on the Tarmac back there. And you can make this bike really slick and sleek. But anyways, guys, I believe the weight of this bike is like 16 pounds, something ounces, in a size 54. That is with the two bottle cages, with the Stages power meter, and with the Revol C38s. It's not a bad build. Absolutely beautiful bike. I just want to share with you guys and let you guys know what the warranty process is, just in case you ever came across it. Maybe you're hyped on it. So we'll see. But anyways, guys, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I'll see you guys.
So just in case you guys are curious, this was an S-Works Tarmac SL7 warranty frame. This is a full Altegra DI2 12-speed buildup. We have two S-Works carbon fiber bottle cages on here. When we have Revol C38 wheels, these wheels retail for about $1,100. And we do have a Stages power meter on here with the Envy handlebar on here. So weighing in at 7.3 kilos. And pounds, 16.02 ounces. Honestly, I know you guys are going to say, oh, that's stupid, that's S-Works. That's not a bad weight, given the wheels that are on here, given that it's an Altegra DI2 and a Stages power meter on there for an S-Works frame for this kind of buildup. That's really not that bad of a weight. The only thing you're missing is pedals and a Garmin on there. But anyways, guys, thank you.